My family is involved in yeshiva almost 100 years because my father was a student in the yeshiva, I think in 1926, until he went actually to college.
When he was a little boy, he used to take three streetcars from his Sen High School, which he attended at a young age of 12, to go to the west side where the yeshiva resided at that time.
My father, that was his life. The yeshiva was his life. I had a terrific experience when I came to the yeshiva. I was really, I had wonderful rabbeim. All the rabbis that taught me the yeshiva, they had a tremendous impression upon me. The Novominska Rebbe was our Rebbe in the afternoon Seder and the night Seder. That changed really, I think it changed our life. The influence of the Novominska made me think that maybe I should try to stay in the Torah world for the rest of my life.
My husband is an extraordinary Talmid Chacham. I watch with admiration as he dedicates his life to Torah learning in every moment of his life. That's what my kids grew up on, and some of their fondest memories are connected with living in the yeshiva building.
Some of my fondest memories are Simchas Torah in the yeshiva, singing Moshe Emes, and then throwing my father up in the air or on a table. Then the excitement surrounded around my father was something that was just so extraordinary and so unique.
Going back to my childhood, I just remember playing in the yeshiva surroundings and always running through the tunnel, and my sister's bas mitzvah was in the building. We would spend many, many Shabbosos there even once we moved out.
I made the closest friends there. I always tell my children, these are my cousins, the Polsteins, the Torskis. We are just so much more than friends. We became family because every Yontif we spent together. Those were just the best times.
Rabbi Friedman, he's brought to the entire yeshiva this feeling of excitement.
One thing you'll hear from everybody is Rabbi Friedman's energy, his enthusiasm, his excitement.
Rabbi Friedman is a bundle of energy.
He had like this energy, never-ending energy.
He makes the Energizer Bunny look slow.
Yeah, and the enthusiasm for Torah was obviously infectious to the kids.
Taught us how to learn, how to be a mensch, and gave me the energy and the excitement and the love for Torah.
Just by example, right, Friedman was he made the Torah delicious, and we just wanted to learn.
He always had simcha, no matter where, what, how. He would always have a smile, always be pumping geschmack in the air, always.
And his enthusiasm is authentic. It's almost like the first time you're falling in love with something, but it's over and over and over again.
He was just born to teach Torah and to learn Torah. It's his life, it's his love, it's his passion. And when you're around that, you feel like you're getting it right from Har Sinai.
Spent a lot of time studying with him at night, and that was the type of person he was. You know, he's was quite spontaneous, but at the same time, when you studied with him, he could be very intense.
He actually had an interesting argument, you could say, with another rabbi who would say, it will be good. He ended every conversation with, it will be good. And he said, you know what? He's wrong. I disagree with him. It is good. It is good right now. It is good. So he's always looking for the good in everybody, and he loves the yeshiva.
My parents, both of them, they really spent their entire life, blood, sweat, and tears, for Skokie Yeshiva. And I say both my parents because my mom as well.
Tamar is an amazing educator. She has had such an impact in her 40 years at Hillel Torah, teaching the kids, teaching teachers how to teach. And Hillel Torah is what it is today, in large part, to Tamar Friedman.
She has an incredible amount of energy, and this is a woman who likes to have fun. So she will seek fun anywhere and anyhow. She's just fun, and she does whatever she wants. She picks a challenge, and she just goes for it.
She is an amazing Oizer Kenegdo when it comes to Rabbi Friedman. And the two of them just make an astonishing couple.
I don't think that there's a couple in Chicago that are as powerful and have had such an impact in their careers, both personally and professionally, on so many students across the community.
They did an excellent job balancing it all. They did a really good job. They were amazing parents. They made a lot of time for us while they still serviced the community, and they were amazing for everybody else.
Both my father-in-law and mother-in-law are extremely involved in our children and their grandchildren. My kids feel very close to them.
My grandson, who's a great-grandchild, calls my father a couple of times a week to just talk to him and connect with him, and he really connects with every single person in the family and out.
They are outgoing, energetic. They're just like fun people to be around.
They're always like just showing people how much they like love them, and they're always like welcoming, and they're just always so fun.
I get to learn with my Saba twice a week. I learn a lot from it. We learn Shnayas, Gemara, sometimes Halacha a little bit.
Mazel Tov, Savta and Saba. We love you.
Mazel Tov, Saba and Savta.
Mazel Tov, Saba and Savta.
Mazel Tov, Saba and Savta.
Mazel Tov, Savta and Saba. We love you.
The yeshiva, you know, has like more or less been my life here, and for the last 40 years. I'm a skokie guy, so I felt, you know, I had a natural feeling for this. I'm able to deal with students that maybe I can help mold their future. So that was a tremendous, you know, feeling for me personally, that I don't know if I did a great job in it, but I tried.
It's a special zchut to be married to such a tzaddik for all these years. On top of being a huge Talmid Chacham and a learner and a lover of Torah, he's also a lover of people, a lover of Gdolim. He loves his family, and we all love him greatly.
My wife is a very special person. She has a broad perspective in the world and about a lot of different things. And she also loves and respects, I think, every person. Having that as a partner in life, realizing how much you gotta do and help out other people, rubs off on me a little bit. I feel like my father and mother, you know, they really maybe deserve this honor more than myself. So what can I say? I mean, can I express thanks for something which is, you know, much, much bigger than me? The honor is, you know, it's above and beyond what I can express in my words.